In 1941, the Japanese invaders began stepping up efforts to wipe out rebels led by the Communist Party of China and destroy their base areas, especially those in North China. A Japanese military record of the event said, while attacking communist rebels in the Jincha-Chi border areas and destroying their base areas, we blockaded them to undermine their self-sufficiency, trap and annihilate communist forces in the region. In August 1941, Japanese troops conducted a large-scale mopping-up operation based in Langya Mountain in Yixin County, Hebei Province. On September 23rd, more than 3,500 Japanese and puppet soldiers launched a surprise attack on Langya Mountain. The situation became critical. Young Chung U, then commander of the 1st sub-region of the Jincha-Chi military region, recalled the time clearly. In the autumn of 1941, we made arrangements and moved west. During the transfer, I learned that the enemy had set up a giant ring of encirclement around the whole of Langya Mountain. Langya Mountain is part of the Taihung Mountains. Located to the southwest of Yixin County, it has 41 peaks, including Chipan To Peak and Lianhua Peak. In the battle, the main body of the 1st Regiment was ordered to defend the military region. The few troops left at Langya Mountain were led by Cho Wei. Cho said to young Chung Wu, "The situation is extremely tense. We have been fighting against the enemy since this morning. Enemy planes have bombed and strafed us several times, and their shells have fallen on Chipan Tu Peak." On the morning of September 23rd, Japanese troops attacked Langya Mountain. Its main body was the 2nd Corps of the Japanese North China Area Army. The commander was Major General Tsuda Mitaki. Under Cho's deployment, the soldiers of the 7th Company, 1st Regiment, disguised themselves as the main body to draw the enemy. The 7th Company and local militias used the natural barriers of Langya Mountain and modified terrains to plant landmines on the enemy's route up the mountain. On September 24th, after nightfall, guerrilla detachments, government officials, and residents of 4 counties quietly evacuated through a 10-kilometer gap in the Japanese surrounding circle that had been torn apart by Chinese troops. Ma Bao Yu, commander of the 6th Squad, 2nd Row, Deputy Commander Ge Zhenlin, and soldiers Hu De Lin, Hu Fu Chai, and Song Shu Yi had one final task. They gathered the boxes of grenades left behind by the regiment and hid them in the most inaccessible positions on Chipanto Peak. Langya means wolf teeth and is named after its strange peaks, which are rugged and steep. The main peak, Lianhua, is 1,105 meters above sea level and stands at the very top of Chipanto. Early on the morning of September 25th, more than 500 Japanese troops launched an attack on Langya Mountain. On the way up, they were held back by landmines. Firing from the machine gun group drew the enemy, who mistakenly thought that the main body of the Chinese army were still on the mountain. The 6th Squad guarded key points of Chipanto. They repelled 4 violent charges from the Japanese army and killed more than 50 of the enemy. By noon, the Japanese army had still not reached Chipanto Peak.
7连与5名战士分开以后，留下了2名机枪手，而当时机枪的子弹也是有限的，也给打光了。但是在当时那种情况下， 这个机枪呢是比人的命更重要。班长马宝玉呢就决定掩护2名机枪手撤离出狼牙山，然后他们继续在棋盘坨上阻击敌人，最后把敌人引上了绝峰。Ma
Baoyu was born in 1920 and a native of Wuxian County. After the Marco Polo Bridge incident in 1937, he joined the 8th Route Army and the CPC. Brave and strong, he used a shovel to kill a Japanese soldier and seize a rifle in a battle. During a night assault, he killed a Japanese machine gunner, paving the way for troops to advance. Next to a cliff leading to the top of Chipanto stands a naturally formed rock that resembles a chessboard, or Chipan in Chinese. According to legend, military expert Sun Bin and his master Gui Guqi often played chess here, giving the peak its name.
我眼前的这个岔路口呢，有两条路，而这一条路呢，就是通往大部队转移的方向。如果当时吴勇士他们如果选择这条路的话，就会暴露出群众和主力部队的目标。 而我前面这条路呢，就是通往三面绝壁的小莲花峰。吴勇士呢，在这里生活了将近2年的时间，对这里的地形呢是非常熟悉的。他们知道这条路就是一条绝路。这个时候，他们就已经放弃了自己生存的希望。他们的目的就是为了能够让主力部队和群众能够更安全地转移出狼牙山去。
Under the leadership of Ma Baoyu and Gu Jianlin, the 5 men turned around without hesitation and made their way towards Chipanto.
この工事は、ローガ山中最も峻峻で、崖を数メートル登るのは、天を登るより困難である。
Chipanto was surrounded by cliffs on 3 sides, with no obstacles to rely on and no route to make a retreat. Under Ma's leadership, the 5 soldiers fought fiercely for 5 hours. Faced with this situation, Japanese 2nd Lieutenant Arioka struggled to encourage his men. The Japanese soldiers were forced to climb one rock wall after another before finally reaching the top of the mountain.
ダーロ黄昏な時候、武勇士バディエン演唱了小莲花峰。就在这个时候呢，他们的子弹打光了，然后他们就用山上的石头往下砸。但是山上能搬动的石头是有限的，也给砸光了。他们手中呢，这时候只剩下了唯一的一颗手榴弹。这颗手榴弹是留给自己的，与敌人同归于尽用的。最后呢，他们把这颗手榴弹也甩向了敌群。バグが行くとも先長らを助け来しました。とっても一斉が良かった。後ろに来た人たちも手榴弾に参加し始めた。逃げ場をなくした敵は絶壁の上で必死に抵抗していた。中を糸を兵が敵から投げてきた手榴弾の爆発で谷の底に転落し絶命しました。
At the final critical moment, the five warriors chose to die rather than surrender. After destroying their guns, they jumped off the cliff. Ma Bao Yu, Hu De Lin, and Hu Fu Chai died martyrs' deaths. Guo Jian Lin and Song Shue Yi fell onto trees on the cliff and survived. In April 1942, the local government erected a memorial tower, On Chi Pan Tuo, to commemorate their heroic deeds. Nie Rong Jin, then commander of the Jin Cha Ji military region, wrote this inscription. Seeing death as a return is the spirit revolutionary soldiers should have. It is the glorious tradition of the heroes of Hebei to die rather than yield. In 2015, on the 70th anniversary of the victory of the War of Resistance against Japanese aggression, the renovated Shanghai Sihang Warehouse Battle Memorial Hall was officially opened to the public. At the most prominent location of the Memorial Hall, sits a huge sculpture of a family letter. It was written by Xie Jinyuan, commander of the 524th Regiment, 88th Division of the National Revolutionary Army, to his wife.
巧因无期爱见，日内即将率部进入松参战，特修寸肩，以慰远念。我神州半壁河山，日遭蚕食，亡国灭种之祸。 发之他人，操之在我。一不留心，子孙无教累矣。为国杀敌，是革命军人素质也。
By October 26, 1937, the Battle of Shanghai had been underway for more than 2 months. More than 1 million soldiers from China and Japan had been engaged on the battlefield. It was a battle of unprecedented intensity, with both sides winning, then losing strategic points several times. Japanese troops had moved straight into Nanxiang and Jiading in a bid to cut off the Chinese army's retreat. At the critical moment, the main body of the Chinese army headed to positions on the south bank of the Shuzhou River and gradually withdrew from Shanghai.
1937年的10月26号 已经撤退，但是撤退的时候呢，中国的统帅部呢不甘心，希望留一支部队留在那里，因为他毕竟是上海的中心城区。最后呢，就决定由谢晋元团副带一个营入驻四行仓库。
32-year-old Xie Jinyuan was from Meizhou in Guangdong Province. One of the Whampoa Academy graduates, he was first admitted into the infantry department and then transferred on to the political department. He was an experienced veteran who had taken part in the Northern Expedition. Just a few months earlier, Xie had sent his pregnant wife, Ling Weicheng, back to his hometown in Guangdong. Before leaving, he told her to name the baby Ji Min if it was a boy.
我父亲就叫我母亲，带领了两个姐姐一个哥哥。我那时候呢，母亲还怀孕，还没有出生，就到广东蕉岭我们的家乡。一个呢，他说这个地方呢，日本人打不到；还有一个呢，我万一在外面有什么事情，我父亲的那个父母没有人照顾。
As Chinese military communications had been interrupted, some soldiers from the 1st Battalion had retreated with the main body of the Chinese Army. When messengers caught up with them, the soldiers immediately turned around and rushed back to Sihang Warehouse.
Bus 是最早在8月12号就进入上海的，从8月13号一直打到了10月26号。他的替换兵已经换了好多，所以四行孤军的这一支部队的主要的是从湖北通州替补过来，缺少战斗经验。
The six-story concrete building on the bank of the Shuzhou River was originally a warehouse jointly operated by four major banks in Shanghai. It would be the last stronghold of Xie Jinyuan and the 1st Battalion, 524th Regiment, 88th Division.
四行仓库呢，它是非常坚固，这个墙很厚，平时呢什么都存。
After coming under fire for more than 70 days, a deadly silence had now fallen over the battle zone of Shanghai.
我父亲呢，他说我先到四行仓库，他过来先把那个88师的交给他的任务四行仓库这个阵地给他接下来，而且呢，并且因为他也熟悉这个地方，然后呢，从底下到楼上重新再看了一下，他脑子就基本上就知道怎么安排这个守卫。
After 1st Battalion entered the warehouse, Xie ordered the soldiers to reinforce the surrounding fortifications. They worked day and night using materials they found in the warehouse to build defensive barriers. When everything was ready, Xie and his army of fewer than 500 people made up their minds to fight to the death. And they claimed to have 800 soldiers. On October 27th, the battle to defend Sihang Warehouse began.
那个时候日本兵第一次来的时候根本就没有把我们放在眼里，就大摇大摆的就这么过来的，因为他们想那么几十万人都跑了，你这么一个小的据点，根本就不在话下吧。But
the Japanese were in for a surprise. The experienced Xie had carefully designed their defensive line. The 200-meter section of Guangfu Road from the outer bunkers to the warehouse formed an ambush circle that awaited the Japanese army.
So, Xie Jinyuan's步伐还是非常有特色。当时呢，他怕就是日军啊，就是偷袭到仓库的近处，所以他在犄角上呢。
在民房旁边的民房呢，留一个班。如果日军要包围仓库的话呢，那个班的士兵就可以从相反方向来射击。我们就等他到靠近的时候，然后我负责三楼，杨营长在二楼，分别的指挥，然后一声命令下呢。 那个楼上的那个仓库里的那个机枪、步枪，还有楼下的机枪、步枪、手榴弹一起把他给打了。打到晚上天看不见了，他就进攻就比较少了。
Late that night, in his report to his superiors, Xie Jinyuan wrote that attacks against the enemy on October 27th killed more than 80. Early in the morning of October 28th, 200 Japanese soldiers prepared to storm the warehouse gate. At the foot of the wall in the southwest corner of the warehouse, more than 70 Japanese soldiers gathered to blast open the gate. This was precisely where the Chinese guns couldn't cover. Right at that moment, one man jumped off the roof of the warehouse.
二连二排的一个四班的一个副班长陈树生，他21岁，他也不要请示，一捆的手榴弹拿好以后拿了导火索以后从就从五楼就跳下来，在两个那个钢板中间钻下去，跟十几个日本鬼子同归于尽。
The bravery of the Chinese soldiers stunned the people on the south bank of the Suzhou River.
它的南岸就是公共租界。当时，所有的记者、关心的市民都在苏州河的南岸实地的拍摄记录这场战役。所以，10月26号的晚上，世界各大媒体开始报道四行孤军的战斗。
On the afternoon of October 29th, the Japanese attacked again, but were repelled. After 3 days of fierce fighting, Xie Jinyuan realized that because the Japanese were afraid of stray debris going into the concession, they did not dare to attack with heavy artillery and only sent infantry troops for the assault. So Xie withdrew the troops back to the warehouse with the machine gun company deployed on the roof to give them the height advantage. The British troops in the concession had a clear view of the battle. At the beginning, they tried to persuade Xie to lay down weapons and pull out. But the Chinese army refused to surrender. The British soldiers were deeply impressed. Major General Alexander Telfer Smollett was the commander of the British army in the concession. He said, "We all fought in World War I, but I've never seen anything more courageous and heroic than the Chinese soldiers defending Jia Bay." The humiliated Japanese army were furious and deployed more troops for a final attack. They blasted the building with 37mm flat trajectory guns and set it on fire, turning it into a sea of flames. The Chinese soldiers resisted tenaciously, repelling the Japanese again. Late at night, there was fragmentary gunfire, and Xie Jinyuan realized that a stronger attack was coming. He told all his soldiers to write farewell letters to their families.
I asked the soldiers to write farewell letters to their families. I said, "Your husband, do you know?
为数不多的认字的战士代替其他的士兵来记录他最后的愿望。所以后来那些老兵他说我们想死就死吧当兵的，但是有一些年纪轻的只有16岁17岁的那些当兵的就有点难过，好像 巧因吾妻爱见，为国杀敌是革命军人素质也。军人不亦有家室，我既有之，且门衰灾薄，亲者丁息，能无眷然矣。老亲之未奉，儿女之教养， 全劳亲承担，以免旅人分心也。晋元。On
October 30th, the Japanese army deployed more firepower to attack the warehouse, firing a shot almost every second. The high-intensity shelling left the entire building severely damaged. Despite the onslaught, the Chinese soldiers were not afraid and fought back bravely. Xie Jinyuan and the more than 400 soldiers at the warehouse fought fiercely for 4 days and nights, repelling more than 10 Japanese attacks and killing more than 200 Japanese soldiers. Today, there are more than 400 bullet holes clearly visible on the walls of the warehouse. These bullet holes tell of the heroic deeds that took place in Shanghai more than 80 years ago.
Sihang 保卫战呢，它起了很多方面的作用。我想最重要就是鼓舞人心，让全世界都知道中国在抗日。 中国在抗击侵略者，而中国的战场是二战当中第一个战场。我们独立坚持抗击侵略者10年，当时上海的音乐家非常的激愤，看了这样的一个场面，就写了《中国不会亡》，来鼓舞中国的军民，学习四行孤军。
At the memorial hall for the 82 heroes at Liu Laozhuang Village in Huai In, Jiangsu Province, there are two ordinary-looking family letters on display. The sender is Li Yunpeng. Li Yunpeng's sister, Li Aiyun, is 73 years old. The two never met. In Li Aiyun's home hangs a kite. It was Li Yunpeng's favorite toy as a child.
My 都能看到，他就是跟我说，你们要像你大哥那样，要像大哥那样活着。Li
Yunpeng was born into a teacher's family in Peixian County, Jiangsu Province. When he was a fifth grader, rebel forces against the Japanese invaders began springing up around China. In class, there was one sentence Li frequently recited: "How can a real man always work with a pen?" In 1939, a troop went to Li's hometown. It was the Su Lu Yu detachment of the 8th Route Army.
八路军的苏鲁豫支队前身是115师六八五团，最早的时候是一体农一团。从北伐战争到土地革命战争，再到抗日战争，始终是一支战功卓著的部队。参加过汀子桥战役、四渡赤水战役。
Li Yunpeng secretly enrolled in the 8th Route Army, and his family only heard from him 2 years later when his father received a letter.
Father 与四县正籍及嘉信一封，不知大人收到否？我已离开此地，转入本省淮阴了，以致嘉阴不能等收，而亦诚为念。The
letter is written strictly in accordance with the traditional Chinese style, which requires parents and other elders to be addressed with a double title as a show of respect.
不知大人,
身体近来健康否？不知家中生活情形和收成怎样，更不知当地情形如何。而在外，甚为惦念之。而在外身体很好，生活也很好，而现在的我比从前粗壮而高大了，请大人不要为难。
In 1941, the Su Lu Yu detachment was ordered to advance east to establish a base area in northern Jiangsu. Later, it was reorganized into the new 4th Army. Li Yunpeng was a political instructor of a company there.
我父亲几次要去看望他，他都是婉言的，就是给父亲解释经常扫荡啊，这个不安宁啊，我所以不希望父亲去冒这个险来看他。
In all the years that Lee was away from his hometown, he and his family never stopped thinking about each other.
Guy, 叔父叔母大人都好吧，侄在外也非常挂念，不知何家弟妹安好否，现在读书没有，望再来信告诉我。我在外也很好，望大人不要挂念，今后望大人多多来信，并祝何家安好。
The northern Jiangsu base area connected to the base areas in Shandong and central Jiangsu and posed a major threat to the rule of the Japanese and their puppets. The new 4th Army damaged the roads, bridges, and communication facilities of the Japanese, leaving them paralyzed for long periods of time. Today, on the monument of the 54th Regiment of the Japanese Army in Okayama Ken, Japan, the Battle of Liutanghe is still described as a heroic military exploit.
第17師団は、キビチ、区内の粛清を図り、大東亜戦争を有利に導くため、共存新種軍の徹底的掃討を目指し、六島側作戦が実施された。
1943年，抗日战争到了湘鄂阶段的后期，日军的中国战场遭到了极大的削弱和消耗。为了改变不利的战略态势，抽调兵力到太平洋战场，侵华日军呢采取梳笔式的扫荡，对于敌后抗日根据地发动了又一次大规模的进攻。
On March 17th, more than 1,000 Japanese troops encircled the leadership organs of the CPC in Huaihai District. The new 4th Army sent a company to cover their retreat by blocking enemy troops from different directions. On March 18th, the 4th Company encountered Japanese troops at Liu Lao Village.
在外边刘老庄那个站岗的有鸣枪，这时候为什么鸣枪？就是看见鬼子太多了，突然的来袭击了，所以他们来不及用话来汇报了，但是鸣枪。
The 82 soldiers of the 4th Company fought bravely against the Japanese by using traffic trenches and finally ensured that the main body of their troops were safely transferred.Heavily surrounded by enemy troops, they tried to break out of the encirclement several times, but failed.
当时敌我的兵力对比是1000比82，而火力的对比呢？据日军绘制的刘老庄附近战斗经过要图显示，日军投入这次作战的重型火器就有联队、野炮中队、机关枪中队和大队。 步兵炮小队这么多的火器。
The northern Jiangsu plain was flat and vast, and the 4th Company had to use traffic trenches beside the road as their positions for the battle.
The 敵は我が方を察知して歩兵砲に発砲してきた。歩兵は射撃を開始し、砲兵砲は陣地に侵入した。この三者は同時であった。
After advancing only 30 meters, the Japanese army was repelled by a barrage of grenade attacks on their first charge.
大隊は抜刀し、先頭に立って投進したが、敵弾を受けて倒れた。生存を祈りつつ、連隊長と幹部が現場へ追求したが、壮烈な戦死であった。
The Japanese army had the absolute advantage. It changed its tactics.And bombarded the positions of the 4th Company with all of its guns, mortars, and grenade launchers. Smoke spread all over the battleground.
This 日军的战报显示，第一大队步兵炮向四连的阵地一口气打光了当日的所在所有弹药，扬起的尘土呢，几乎是盖住了李云鹏所在的战壕。由于弹药浪费很严重，炮兵小队长还遭到了大队长的一顿臭骂。
From early morning to dusk, the 4th Company stood firm and calm in front of the powerful enemy. They fought a bloody battle, repelling 5 consecutive attacks and killing nearly 100 enemy soldiers.
向他们喊话，说要你们投降吧，你们没有出路了，现在就是你们投降，不愿意投降，明抢就是明抢。后来他们八十连是最后还是明抢，坚决不投降。
The setting sun that day was blood red.Those who witnessed the life or death struggle were presented with a shocking scene. These warriors had decided to give their lives to the country and had fought to the end. In the face of certain death, these 82 tenacious Chinese soldiers gave their last drop of blood for their cause.This warped rifle at the Liu Lao Village Memorial Hall gives an idea of the cruelty and ferocity of the battle. Despite its rust, it bears witness to the bravery and loyalty of the officers and soldiers of the 4th Company.On July 7, 1943, commander of the new 4th Army, Chen Yi, wrote, Of the 82 soldiers, including Commander Bai Sitsai, Deputy Company Commander Shou Zhifu, Political Instructor Li Yunpeng, Culture and Education Director Sun Zunming, Row Commander Wei Qingzhong, Zhang Yuanlian, and Liu Dengfu, none surrendered.All of them passed away. How heroic. At the Huaiyin Martyrs Cemetery, stand 82 sturdy green pines. Each tree was carefully planted by local residents to commemorate those heroes. After the war, the new 4th Army re-established the 4th Company and renamed it Liu Lao Village Company. On September 3, 2015, China celebrated the 70th anniversary of the victory in the Chinese People's War of Resistance against Japanese aggression. A square array representing the 82 soldiers appeared at the commemoration parade. After having gone through a test of history, this legendary unit marched in the procession of heroes of the People's Liberation Army.
而现在心目中所最挂念着以我年老辈辞之祖母而离家时祖母曾染重疾不知大人的病痊愈了否身体健康否不知祖母饮食起居怎样而心中非常挂念这次离家为报此恩反而离家 是我之罪过也待风息波静凯然而归全家团聚以报此恩